guys, Michael J. Solar here with Dog Talk, and I'm so excited because as we promised last week, we told you that that Blue Line Canine was going to be sponsoring a race team, and I have the race team down here today. This is Anderson's race team, now going to be Blue Line Canine, which is really exciting. And I have to tell you that what makes this like so rewarding, you guys have no idea, is that when we originally, so hold on, I got to tell the backstory. So one, this guy right here. So we are practicing social distancing. They are actually farther behind me. I can't touch, right? So we can see it. So with that being said, so Sean and I actually worked together back at the Cecil County Detention Centers where we started our law enforcement careers and careers of all this kind of stuff together. And Sean had reached out to me last week to see about sponsoring his race team, which is his son, Liam. That is the driver, yeah? So what happened was he reached out to me. He told me about this kind of stuff. I'm like, yeah, sure, I love giving back. And bam, next thing I know, we find out that Liam loves to race for the cure and supporting childhood cancer research and giving back to the community. So it just wound up getting bigger and better the more and more we talked about it. And I'm so excited to bring them out here today. So Sherry and Tara, hello. And now we're going to introduce everybody here. So we have Sean, we have Liam, and Charlie. And Charlie's actually one of the sponsors as well. He's the gentleman we talked about with the Relic Recovery. So if you guys are looking for your jewelry because you lost it one of those, you know, nights in your backyard with those bonfires, he's definitely the guy to give a call because he's going to come out and find it. Isn't that right?
Yes.
He's a little nervous, as you guys can see. So what we want to do is want to make this conversation nice and interactive. I know it's going to be a slight sidetrack from our normal conversations about dogs, but this is a really cool time that we all get together, especially as we enter into November, which is the season of Thanksgiving. So this is one of those fun times to get everybody together and have this. So again, if you're watching the show and you have questions, or if you're just curious about things, please feel free to ask. Hey, Bruce, yes, we do. So the answer to that one, we do train them. So feel free to give us a call or ask in a couple minutes. But I want to bring Liam up here to talk a little bit about what got him in the racing. So Liam, I'm going to ask that you talk up a little loud to make sure that we can hear you perfectly fine. But just tell us the story about what got you into racing.
Well, when I was 3 years old, my mom died by cancer. And since that then, we started supporting cancer. And then my dad took me to Nicholson Speedway one time, and we looked around, and I told Daddy, I want to get into this. And well, I did, and I loved it. It's fun. And I'm excited for this year because I'm having a teammate, and yeah.
He's pumped up. So one of the cool things about Blue Line Canine, which is really something I've been proud about, is that Blue Line Canine, we believe that everybody has to be a champion for their dog. And when we talk about being a champion for your dog, it doesn't mean always winning the race, but it's taking on the challenge of giving your dog an opportunity to have the awesomest time in the life with them, giving back to them, taking them out with them, giving them the best form of training and multiple things. So here at Blue Line Canine, we've always pushed the point of being a champion for your dog. So we actually have an actual wrestling championship belt made. And we're going to have Liam actually hold this for the entire time here because now that he is a part of the Blue Line Canine family, he's now a champion. Because what we found about Liam is that he was actually a champion since we can remember. I mean, literally, I just got the opportunity to meet him. And as you can hear from this little story he gave, how he's out there fighting and leading the way. I mean, seriously, you can really learn a lot just from him. And Liam, how old are you?
Eight.
8 years old, ladies and gentlemen. 8 years old, and he's out there racing for a cure. So I can't say this. I mean, here's a kid that literally just told you a story about facing adversity, and instead of letting it get down, him and his father decided to team up and give back. So Sean, tell us some of the challenges that you guys face when it comes into racing and things like that. It's traveling and what else kind of things that you come across that you know, you look for support from people and how you raise money to give back?
Just looking for support, but one of the biggest challenges, of course, overall, is trying to get people to understand what we do and the reason why we do it. As you can imagine, there for the longest time, just trying to raise a kid, you know, that we had both lost his mother from cancer at the age of in her early 20s. It's not an easy thing to go through. It's just one of those things where you try to figure out, okay, how can I take all this negativity and turn it into something good? Well, there's a lot of different ways you can do that. And one of the biggest ways is to educate yourself and to understand the reason why we do what we do, because childhood cancer is so much different from adult cancer. And one of the reasons why we raise money for that is because, of course, his mom loved children so much. But with that being said about, you know, childhood cancer being so different, 1 in 200,000 children every year worldwide get diagnosed with cancer. So it's not an easy thing to overcome. It's not an easy thing to research. And one of the reasons for that is because it's so underfunded. So we decided to join the fight to do that. And there's a lot of foundations out there that are just overall not really supporting the cause. It's you know, supporting the CEOs, private jets, and things like that. Yet they have staff on the payroll, and you know, just out of professionalism, we don't mention those. But we just decided to try to help out locally, and there's quite a few ways you can do that if you reach out to us.
Thanks, John. So, real quick, so Bruce, you asked if we train Chihuahuas. I don't know if you saw in the back on over Charlie's shoulder, there was the Chihuahua running around. In case anybody hasn't figured out, we're not at my home office. We're actually at the Blue Line Canine Training Center in Joppa. So we're so that way we were able to keep some proper social distancing while talking tonight. Now, Sean, it's an amazing thing to hear how you guys have come through this. You're giving back to the community. You're really pumping up to something that is not easy to find. And like anything else, you know, as we know, this is a dog talk show, and we talk about this, and what's awesome about having this is that Blue Line Canine is able to be a part of this and able to grow your team and your fundraising and everything that you're trying to do. So it's really neat to see how this is really connecting us all. And that's one of the things that we really love about Dog Talk, you guys, Blue Line Canine, and that's why we're able to give back is because of you. And one of the things I have to say that, you know, Sean, you're a single father raising your son. You're teaching them the right way. And this is really what also comes back to the people out there with their dogs, you know, giving them the right foundation. You never know what you can open the doors to. And this is really what I'm honored to have you guys here. So again, I just also want to let everybody know that if you are on the show, you have questions, comments, please put them in the comment section. We can see them. We can answer them. So from Mo, cancer survivor myself, how can I help? Love Blue Line Canine. Awesome. So, Sean, what we're going to do, I guess what we'll do on a different episode, there are some things. So Sean actually has a Facebook page dedicated to the team. What is your direct hashtag?
So the hashtag is Racin, R-A-C-I-N, the number 4, and Mommy. That will link directly to our Facebook page, Blue Line Canine Race Team.
So what we'll do later is, actually, let me figure this out here. What is the ad of the page?
Say again?
What, do you know how to get directly to your page?
Just with that hashtag. So put that hashtag in the
racing
search bar. It's R-A-C-I-N, the number 4, and Mommy. And that will link directly to your Facebook page.
Is it going to be M-O-M-M-Y or I-E?
With a Y.
All right, guys. What I did was I put that hashtag directly in the comment section below. It would mean a lot to all of us if you're able to go ahead and like, follow, and share the page to help them raise money for what they're doing. Again, this is a very noble cause that we had to take time out to just literally talk to them about this kind of stuff. So it's really neat how we're always able to give back. And like I said, creating a family and creating a surrounding of support, it goes from everywhere, from dog training into the real humans, right? So we talk about Pavlov, we talk about operant conditioning, we talk about the clever Hans effect. When you work with us and you learn how to train, it's not just about sit down, come and stay. It's about leadership and showing the right direction to your animals, but as well as our children, because they are our futures. So you can really take a lot from Sean as he led his son and down a noble cause, and you can really see how Liam is doing this kind of stuff. So I want to ask Liam, so now that you've been racing, how long have you been racing?
This is my first season.
It's your first season. Now, so this is your first brand new season. You already finished one. Aren't you in one right now that you're finishing up?
Yes.
You're finishing up one right now. He's finishing up the race season right now.
He's only finished outside the top five one time.
Wow, only one time outside of the top five. So you can see for a brand new guy, he's out there. He's already given NASCAR a run for their money, right? So tell us a couple of things that goes through your mind when you're out there. Is it don't crash or is it how fast can I go? Give me something that goes through your mind while you're out there.
How fast can I go?
How fast can he go? So that's one of the neat things out there. Now, we were trying to figure out a way to actually bring his car in here to let you guys see it. We were unable to do that. The doors weren't big enough for that car, and we couldn't get it, into the camera angle type of little things like that. So what we're hoping to do down the road is that, again, if you get on his page, you can see his car. I know when I first saw it, I was pretty blown away. I never thought of a go-kart looking and being as fast as it was. The only thing I can tell you is I wish I was a lot smaller and lighter to be a part of that.
It's not too late.
It's not too late. Yeah, I think my family would get mad if I crashed. So I have a weird feeling nobody wants me hurt anymore. So they want to keep me healthy and out here on the field training. So a couple of good things that we're looking for is, again, if you guys have any questions, comments, please feel free to put them in there. We are waiting for one person to get on, which is Chase from Elite Espantoons or Elite Custom Gifts. He has two different companies there. One is with the Espantoons, and obviously he's doing Elite Custom Gifts. He was supposed to be one of our guests, but he did send him a link. He didn't log in yet. So I do want to give him a shout out. If you're looking for something as we're coming into the holiday season, please check him out. So other than what we have going on tonight, I have to take a quick second to let everybody know about all these fun announcements. Number one big announcement we have coming in, if you're not following us, is that Blue Line Canine is now at the Boag Pet Resort. That is right. We are bringing the Canine Country Club, where you can sign up for memberships, get your dog mentally stimulated with fit canine, obstacle course, scent work, field trips, and many, many more things. If you're looking for the overnight kenneling overnight boarding during the holiday season as we come into November, December of the year, please feel free to reach out to 1-800-266-2365. We'll get you booked up for overnight care at Boag Pet Resort and Blue Line Canine. This is really exciting stuff because we're also going company-wide, giving $500 off of our stay-and-train program. So that means Raleigh and Maryland, all locations in the Baltimore region, are all giving $500 off of our stay-and-train program. So again, when you're supporting us, you're also supporting them. So make sure you're giving and you're helping and you're looking for the best dog training, getting yourself on top of things like that. So if you guys have any questions, thoughts, concerns, please feel free to post them in there. We can answer dog training questions now. And if you have questions for Liam, Sean, please feel free to ask them. If not, I'm going to ask some more questions to Mr. Liam. So how fast does your car actually go?
50
miles per hour.
That's correct.
Okay, wow. So he's driving on a racetrack at 50 miles per hour at the age of eight. Okay, that's pretty crazy, right? So when you're coming off the track, right, how fast is your heart beating at that point in time?
Probably.
That's fairly mellow, right? So Liam here is a new champion, and I'm really so happy that he's able to take up our brand and go out there and fight for this cure for childhood cancer, and as well as bringing awareness to what cancer has been doing to our society. I mean, honestly, when you take a leader like him at the age of 8 years old, I can't wait for everybody to follow him and see what else he's going to be bringing to the table. Because if he's 8 years old already leading the way now, when he's 18, who knows? I mean, I guess the sky's the limit at this point in time. He's wearing that belt right now like a champ right now. That, just to let everybody know, that belt is not light. Is it?
No.
It's
never even close. I don't think I can even. No, I can't.
Let's see.
Maybe.
Can you hold it up like the Rock? There he is. He's you smell what the Rock is cooking, right? So here's the big thing that we look at here is that when you take a champion like him, he didn't even know he was going to be able to get that belt on him today. And it's really cool to see that he's holding it like a champ. He hasn't tried to put it down, but that thing is no joke. It is pretty heavy. So a couple of cool things that I also want to point out to you guys is Sean, as you can see, is biting his lip in agony because I have him on Facebook. As the famous words, as I said just before we went live, was, it's just Facebook, Sean. And I think he wanted to punch me. I'm going to be honest. I think he wanted to hit me. I think he wanted to hit me. So What I wanted everybody to do real quick, if you guys don't mind, can you put a comment below just telling you that you support Sean and Liam and their race for childhood cancer research, because it's really important that we get out there and we get everybody liking, sharing this page with Dog Talk.
And Travis.
And oh yeah, and that's right. My son's going to be joining the team next year. With Travis is going to be on the team, but we're going to hope to, we're going to bring everybody in the team when we get everything locked and loaded here real soon. So this is really big to be bringing in, because it's an awesome thing that we're getting to be a part of. Now, since you brought up Travis, I'm going to have to say that there's something even more to that, which is my wife Tara is also a cancer survivor. So she's a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma cancer survivor. She did this when she was a young teenager, survived prior to even getting going. And one of the biggest things that Tara and I have always wanted to do was give back to cancer research, cancer survivors, but more importantly, just give to them directly. And when Sean reached out, he didn't mention any of this to us when we first started this. And when it came back, it really is one of those things where it really touches home to know that they're doing it. So Sean actually is bringing my son on the team as well. And it's really cool that my son now gets to be a part of this and this journey, because I know it means a lot to me. It means a lot to my wife. It means a lot to the Blue Line Canine family as well. So it is a very inspirational thing. And the biggest thing I could say is thank you guys, because if it wasn't for any of you, none of this is possible. And that is the God honest truth. If you weren't supporting us, we wouldn't be able to support them. So I just want to say thank you to all of you for being there for us, supporting Blue Line Canine. And again, as we continue to grow, and I want to say thank you for being a part of our growth. And remember, we're here for you as well. So if you ever have any questions, thoughts, concerns, always feel free to reach out to bluelinecanine.com or give us a call at 1-800-266-2365. And you know, let everybody know we are doing tons and tons of more stuff. So if anybody has any other questions, thoughts, concerns, please feel free to put them in the comments as we continue through. I also want to let everybody know that the special for the if you go to the Blue Line Canine store and you're looking for the socialization booklet, that is still going away for free with the coupon code of DogTalk101. That's again DogTalk101. So going back to Sean and Liam, I have a couple of more questions, which is one, where are some of your races held so we can tell people where they're at?
So currently we're racing all over the state of Maryland. Currently we're running three tracks just to start the season out. Next Sunday we'll be at Nicholson Speedway, which is in Chestertown, Maryland. And the cool part about that is Liam just got a new GoPro 8. So we can broadcast live right off the nose of his go-kart as he's going around the track. So we're hoping that you would tune in to the page.
Okay, so that's going to be live on the Facebook page?
No, it's going to be live on my Facebook page, because I could not link the racing page to the GoPro until I get some tech to figure that out.
Okay, so we have to figure out how to get it on the live. So how would they get to your do you have to be your friend then, or to get it?
Yeah, absolutely. I wouldn't mind a few friend requests. Probably 100,000.
So Sean's looking for some friends, guys. So if you're looking for Sean, go to Sean Anderson. Yep, okay, Sean Anderson, at Sean Anderson. Yep. So at Sean Anderson, you guys can go and be his friend. Apparently, he's looking for some more friends on Facebook, so you guys can watch him.
I only have Mike on either.
It's good, guys. So if you're looking for him, get out there. We're cheering you all the way from Huntsville, Alabama. You're an inspiring young man. We look forward to seeing you and what you'll be doing next. How awesome is that, man? You got a shout out from Huntsville, Alabama. Do you know what they do in Huntsville? I don't know either. No, I'm kidding. They actually do a lot of NASA stuff, building rockets and stuff. Matter of fact, you know, it's only a little while. I think it's like 30 minutes south of Huntsville is Talladega. Look at that. You're down in Huntsville getting Talladega people to look up. So, you know, that's big NASCAR racing down there. So you're getting a shout out all the way from Huntsville. How awesome is that, ladies and gentlemen? He got a shout out from Huntsville, Alabama. That is pretty, pretty cool. So giving a couple of shout outs is to Bruce. I want to let you know we do train the Chihuahuas. Again, I'm going to point out that was one running around all night long in the training center here. We have tons of trainers that are directly dedicated to working with small dogs as well as big dogs, behavioral modifications, and many, many more. So going into the next week's session, I want to let everybody know that next week we're going to be talking about some really good topics, one of which is some of the science behind dog training. I'm going to be doing a little bit of a PowerPoint about Pavlov and possibly even Clever Hans or maybe even operant conditioning. So these are big things to be paying attention to. So if you're really looking for the why and not just the how your dog is listening, I hope that you get to join us next week for Dog Talk as we go into the real science behind dog training as it is, okay? So any questions, thoughts, concerns as we get ready to wrap our show up tonight? We'll wait for some more comments and questions. I think it's awesome that you guys are getting real support from everybody out there. And again, we are so thankful for every one of you guys watching, listening, tuning in, and we're gonna get right back into the dog training next week with some awesome information. So if you are looking for some more inspiration, business conversations, also check out our Stuck in the Truck every Wednesday at 8:30 at the Official MJ Solar on Facebook. So you can go right to facebook.com/officialmjsolar and watch live Stuck in the Truck, or you can always watch episodes at blk9tv.com. Again, that is blk9tv.com, and as we continue along this journey. So we have our race team, which I am honored to have my son and wife being a part of soon, next joining next season. Looking forward to the science behind it. Absolutely, Karen, you're gonna absolutely love it. There is nothing fun or nothing more fun than learning the why, because when you learn the why, the how becomes 10 times more easy. So if you guys are looking during the holiday season for boarding, overnight, doggy daycare, we got you covered. Just give us a call at 1-800-266-2365. Blue Line Canine has got your back. So feel free to reach out to us. And if that is it, everybody, we will all see you next week. Thanks.